We'd like to say it's good to see everybody here this morning. Thank you for being with us. It's a beautiful day. How many's glad to be alive?
Amen.
I mean, really, just thanking the Lord that you're able to get up and get about and do the things that you do. You know, so many times we take the little things for granted. We take just being able to get up and come to church for granted. Just being able to get up and to have mobility and to do the things. And we just want to make a day that we thank Him for being so good to us, right there. Amen. I want you to remember, and I want to make this announcement while everybody's fresh and alert. Our church will be starting our first Sunday at Russell Nursing Home today. We will be there at 3:00. Brother Dean's in charge of our mission work down there. We'll be starting there at 3:00. And Brother Doug Bloodworth, one of the young preachers of our church, he'll be with us, and he'll be bringing the message, and we want you to pray for him. And if you can't come be with us, back us up, help Brother Dean and the young preachers of our church to do a good work and to take some good news down there to them folks at Russell Nursing Home right there. So remember that. Also, we want to thank the Lord for Miss Gwen being back with us this morning. We are glad to have her with us. Give the Lord a hand. Amen. Amen. We appreciate that. That's a wonderful sight, seeing her sitting there. Just thank the Lord for that. And I got some good news this morning. I talked with the grandmother of Alexander, and if nothing don't happen, he'll be greeting us with his presence for the first time next Sunday on Young Folks Day. So we thank the Lord for that right there, and we appreciate him right there. Got a lot more prayer requests I want you to remember. Got a lot of folks. I want you to remember Ryan and Brittany. I want you to pray for them. They're twins. Their twins are still in the hospital, John David and Henry Grace. I want you to pray for them. I want you to pray that God will just have his hand in their life. Just remember that God will just help that family. Amen. If you don't know what it was like, or if you don't remember what it was like to be 20-something years old and have 5 kids, I would want somebody to pray for me. Amen. I really would. Really would. 5 kids and 3 of them ain't walking good. Amen. I keep going. It keeps getting worse and worse, don't it? Amen. But remember that family. Amen. God is able to help them and to get them through it. We just pray that they won't give up on the Lord. They'll just keep trusting Him right there. I want you to remember that. Anybody else got a prayer request this morning?
Remember my brother, Jackie, please.
That's right. Remember this. Linda's brother.
Right, we had a new grandbaby going on Wednesday.
That's right.
2.5 weeks early, but she's doing good. She's little. But they're going to take her back every day to check her jaundice levels. So keep them in your prayers. Everything will go okay with that.
Amen. Appreciate that. What's her name?
Kenley Ruddy. Oh, I'm sorry. Tegan Ruddy. I'm so sorry.
Who? Yes, ma'am.
I read that right before coming to church. It's Tegan Ruddy.
All right, we'll write that down for the preacher right there. It'll take the preacher a while on that. But remember that. And also remember Rodney and Julie. They went back to the hospital this morning. They're doing a little memorial for Tenley up there at the hospital. And they've gone up there, and they wanted the church to remember them right there. Anybody else got a prayer request this morning?
I'd like you to remember me and my brothers and sisters.
Amen.
Listen. Brother Frank, I want y'all to remember Maureen from the gym. I spoke with her last night, and she does have been some problems. She said, I'm going to pray for the best. And she goes back to surgeon next week and just going to, pray for the best. So y'all just remember her.
Amen.
The Lord knows all about it.
So,
Brother Frankie, y'all remember Elijah has a doctor appointment on Wednesday to see about the possibly getting surgery from his knee. And y'all just remember him right now.
Amen.
Brother Frankie, y'all remember our cousin Tim Garrett had open heart surgery last week.
Yes, sir.
Go away with him.
Yes, sir. Remember that. How many's got an unspoken request this morning? Let it be known by raising your hand all over the house. We asked two of the brethren to come around and take up this morning, Brother Dwayne and Brother Tony. I know we forgot birthdays, but I didn't see nothing wrote up here. So if anybody's got one, we'll get you at the end of church, okay? Is that all right with everybody?
Amen.
Amen. If it ain't, we'll still do it that way, okay? Smile at me, y'all. It's gonna get better, I promise, right there. All right, nothing else to be said. We'll ask Brother Glenn to ask the blessing on the offering and the prayer request, and we'll go further with our sermon.
Frank, if I can say something real quick. Saturday, about a singing. It seems like building down here is going a little slow from my end perspective. I've got to do the final work to put the roof on. Lord bless me with a tremendous amount of work. I got to finish a job so I can start another job. It's got to be finished next week. So in the meantime, I'm thinking, how am I going to get down here and get this roof on? Frank ain't got my building up for me yet. They ain't got this. They haven't got that. I got to order the metal. We talked this morning in Sunday school about punctual service. If I add everything up to what I got to do next week, Brother Grady, I've got probably maybe six things I really got to accomplish. Got to keep the family going. I've got a job to do. I got to finish this. I've got to order some metal. I've got to put some metal on. What if I have God's job? Listen to Larry. Frank. Listen to Grady with his problems. Listen to Frank. Listen to Jimmy. Listen to every single person in the world. Everyone. Because the ones that don't know him, he's watching out for a break for that opportunity to knock on that door. I've got six problems for a week. He's got millions and millions and millions a day. Maybe he didn't handle your finances quite as quick as you wanted. That gentleman that Dwayne's praying for, a little more important than your finances, go get you.
That's right.
You keep praying. That guy's a little more important. Scott, I don't know how it's going to happen. It might be Friday night. I come up here with my boy and we set lights. And we hang metal in a rain. God knows it'll be ready. But if I can get out of the way, does we still deny ourselves enough? Put God on the back burner. You want to take the lead? Take his job. You deal with my problems. You deal with Frankie's problems. You deal with the ones that don't even know. You'll thank him that much more.
Yep. Brother Frank, if I could just say something real quick, you know, I want to give God the praise and the glory this morning because there were several big things that happened last week and God handled it with just perfect grace and mercy. The mercy and grace that he showed.
What happened?
I can't even explain it. I can't even go into detail, but if you could just know that if that person doesn't know that God loves them and that God handled that situation for them, they'll never know. They'll never know. And I just wanted to give him all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory for
everything. Amen. Amen. I asked him to come on down, and all the kids 5 and under that want to go to the nursery this morning can go with Miss Ashley and Mr. Eric right there. Because Larry, I wanted to start where Larry left off. I'm proud that my God's bigger than a Larry. Yeah. And I'm proud Larry is not my God.
Amen.
God will get it done to where Larry gets time to do it or not. God's not dependent on you. You're dependent on God. Amen. See, I hear, oh, look out, preacher. Amen. It ain't about what you can do. It's all about what God can do. Amen. Amen. Say amen.
Amen.
I hear too many folks act like God's depending on you. God will get it done where you get it done or not. Amen.
Amen.
Look out, preacher. Amen.
Come on, Frank.
I got to slow down here. No, just slow down just a little bit right here. Because I want us to realize, amen, that we're not on, God's not on our timetable, but we're on His.
That's right.
Amen. Listen to me. I love you today. Hey, listen, and I come out here yesterday, and I told the men that were working here, and I got me some extra minutes this morning, no singing, so I can talk a little bit. Amen. But I seen men out here that did not know how to lay block. And that's including me. Amen. But we come together, and God said, now you have, in your church is made up of Nehemiah people.
Yes, sir.
What are Nehemiah people? Can I tell you what Nehemiah people are? They're not professionals at nothing.
Right.
And this is what God showed me on the way home. I'd rather have a church of Nehemiah people than a church full of professionals. Amen.
Yes, sir.
Now look up that word professional. Amen. Those are people that don't need help. Amen.
Yes.
They're supposed to be able to do the job. But Nehemiah people didn't have nothing else. Amen. And they laid these blocks and they come together. And when I went down there, when I looked at them blocks, they looked as good as anything. And when I look at them now, I won't look at how professional they were laid. But I will remember it come together because some of the men of this church had a mind to get down there and get it done.
Amen.
Amen. Now listen to me. Now listen to me. Hey, I'm not a professional tent hanger, amen? But God did, and I want y'all to quit hollering for rain.
Bless
you. Quit hollering for it. You keep asking for it, God's going to see it. I want somebody to pray, don't let it rain.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Preacher, Larry said he's going to hang tent in the rain. We ain't asking for it, amen. But I want us to pray this week. I want us to earnestly. I know what Miss Sherry's talking about. I talked to that person this week on the phone, on the thing, and he let me know that he knows definitely where all his help come from and that he appreciated everything that God did.
Amen.
Amen. Now look, ain't everybody happy this morning? Amen. We get our mind on the right thing. Amen. And we can just get the job done. But let's quit asking for rain. I know Carrie Mitten thinks it's going to rain. But guess what? She don't turn it on and turn it off.
Amen.
Hey, mate.
Yes, sir.
Somebody say
amen.
I know a God that did not let it rain for 3.5 years. Amen.
That's right.
I think they're like little Jamie. Right. Hey, listen. There's a God that can take His hand and it can rain all over, but on the football field and over there, it can be as dry as dust.
Yes,
I just preached this morning. Amen. 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 We've got to come to the realization, amen, we work for God. God doesn't work for us.
Amen.
Bless Him, Jesus.
Amen. Now listen, I'm with Brother Jimmy. If it does, if God sees His will to prove us, to test us, and send the rain, we will do our best to do everything we can to have it indoors. But I'm praying to a great big God.
That's right.
Amen. That He can hold it back. Amen.
Yes,
hey, the devil tells me all the time, it's not going to work. It's not going to happen. Amen. I told him the other night, we're going to have a singing.
Yes,
if me and Miss Petey have to sing. Amen. Amen. And we have to eat sandwiches. We're going to have a singing. Say amen.
Amen.
Hey, I'm so glad through all of our troubles, we have a God that is big enough to handle them, amen. Amen, amen. I didn't come to preach about a God that can't. I come to preach about a God that can.
Amen.
Amen. It's time that we put a smile back on our face this morning. It's time that we get to realizing that this world might be in an awful shape, but the same God is looking over us that's been there all the time, amen. Listen to me. Somebody said, preacher, can God take care of us? We'll go back in history to the early 1900s. There was a great depression that fell up on this world and on the United States. And do you know that Grandma said they did not go hungry? Amen. Do you know that Grandpa said that God was real in those days? Amen. Listen to me. He said it was a little bit harder, but He still supplied. Amen. Anybody want to say God's still real this morning? Amen. Anybody want to talk about how real God is instead of about how dead you think He is, but how good and how real that He is. And that's what we're going to continue this morning. Amen. Listen, I know Zach, it ain't on. Amen. Amen. You pray. Flash Gordon here for the takeoff. Amen. You pray. Amen. I told you, all we had was some preachers don't even know how to hang a thing. Matthew 17. Amen. Matthew 17, we're going back there. A couple of weeks ago, I started a series of messages out of this right here. And last week, for you that wasn't with me, we preached on things that the church need to realize. Amen. Now, where'd you get this from, preacher? Well, let's read our scripture. Amen, Brother Jamie, when we get through reading our scripture, you get ready to pray. I want you to pray for us this morning before we get started. Glad to have Brother Jamie and his wife with us. Amen. I hope he considers me a friend. I consider him one. Amen. We want him to pray. Stand with me when we read the Word of God. Luke 17, verse 11. And it came to pass as he went to Jerusalem that he passed through the midst of Samaria and Galilee. And as he entered into a certain village, there met him 10 men that were lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back and with a loud voice glorified God and fell down on his face and at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answered and said, were there not 10 cleansed? But where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God save this stranger. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. Brother Jamie.
Father, we come to you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this day. Lord, the privilege, Lord, to be in your house this morning, to gather around your people. Father, I pray, God, this morning, Lord, you'd anoint Brother Frankie. God, I pray you'd hide him behind the cross. God, I pray you'd give him unction, Lord, from another world. God, let him preach, Father, like it might be his last time, God, to mount the pulpit, Father, for your honor and your glory. God, I pray this morning, Lord, that you lift up your people, God. Lord, take the frowns, Lord, and the burdens and the worries of this world, God. And I pray you lift them up, God. They've got a need here this morning, Lord. Lord, they're trying to come together as a church to get things done. Father, I pray, God, that you meet the need this morning. God, I'm glad this morning that you're still the God of glory. God, you're still in charge of this thing. Lord, no matter what the world may say, God, you're still on the throne. God, I pray this morning, there's one lost this morning. Oh, God, that today would be the day. Oh, that they'd call on thy name, Lord, and be saved. Father, have your way, Lord. Do what needs to be done in the hearts and minds of your people, God, that you might receive honor and glory out of this service. Lord, touch Brother Frankie, Lord, one more time. God, help him to preach, Lord, thy precious word. Lord, we ask these things for Jesus' sake and in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
Amen. You be seated. Focusing this morning on this one verse, and when he saw them, he's on the 15th verse, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back with a loud voice and glorified God. Last week, we talked about that 1 out of 10 really realize what's going on today. And we talked about that the church needs to realize what time it is, Brother Kenneth. And we went to 2 Timothy chapter number 3 and we preached the word. Paul told Timothy, he said, perilous times would come. And it's time that the church realizes that them times are here now. Brother Bert, those times, we're not waiting on them any longer. Amen. We are living in those days where the devil is doing, he's running rapid over this world, trying to deceive everybody he can, Paul, trying to deceive them and get them to walk away. Amen. And we preached how it's time that folks realize how in the 2 Timothy chapter number 3 and verse number 13 that Paul told Timothy, he said, Timothy, it ain't going to get no better, but things are going to wax worse and worse. Amen. It ain't going to get no better. Amen. It's time for us to quit living in a fairy tale world. Amen. We got to realize the next great event to take place in the Word of God is the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And we need to realize, amen, it's time to get ready. Amen. Time to get ready. Amen. I know that folks want me to tell them that there's going to be a great revival and there's going to be a great coming back to the Lord. But Brother Jamie, I just don't see it happening in the world that we live in. Amen. You say, preacher, the Bible said that there would be a famine in the land that we live in, not for bread and water, but from what? The hearing of the word of God. Amen. There's more intelligent preachers now. Marshall, there's more preachers with greater intellect. There's more preachers that got more smarts. Now, I know smarts might not be the right word, but more smarts than ever before. They can quote you scripture. They can tell her. But what we have today is a family for the hearing. Amen. Now, the accepting, to accept the word of God and apply it to my life. Do you know a preacher can preach till he can give out? He can preach till he's wringing wet. But if you don't accept the word of God and let it move into your life, all his preaching is in vain. Amen. Amen. Listen to me today. I want to preach to you on a few things. Now, last Sunday was real hard, wasn't it, Jimmy? We had to endure a whole lot. Amen. We went through some struggles. Amen. We realized how bad it is. Amen. But this Sunday, we want to preach on just a few things that the church needs to realize. Amen. That God, number one, you can write this down. You realize that God is still in control. Amen. It don't matter how bad this world gets. It don't matter how big the devil gets. Hey, I've got news for you. I've got a God, amen, that is still in charge. Amen. I've got a God that says live, and I'm going to live. He says die, and I'm going to die. I've got a God. Amen. It don't matter what the world says. The Bible says if God be for me, then who can be against me? I want you to realize this morning we're still on the winning side. I want you to realize we have not been defeated. We might be in the battle of our life, but we ain't lost. Amen. You got to realize. You got to be lifted up. You got to be remember this. That in 1 Corinthians chapter number 10, verse number 13, he said, for every temptation, he said, she gets every once in a while, she'll get a B12 shot. She got poor blood. I think we need a B12 shot this morning. But we need to realize that the blood has covered all of my sins. Amen. Oh, listen to me this morning. I come to preach that. Hey, I got you. Now, this is what got me stirred up. They something happened to this one leper that the other nine did not realize. And when he realized it, you know where he found himself at? He found himself back at the feet of Jesus. But when we come to realize that God is still in control, we'll find ourselves back, amen, at the feet of Jesus, amen. Amen. So listen to me, Elisha. I know that you are a young man looking for your future. Amen. Now listen to me. This is what the devil don't want you to realize. He wants you to think that it's hopeless. Amen. He wants you to think that, listen to me, that in this world, but I want to tell you something. Amen. This little leopard seen, there was still hope to be found. Amen. There in the Bible, in verse, in Psalms chapter 46. Amen. Y'all smile. We sung a good bit. I didn't think, can I help y'all today? If y'all don't realize that God's in control and that God still cares, all the singing in the world ain't going to do you no good. Amen. God wants you to get charged up. Brother Larry, he'll bless you to get the word done. Amen. Quit worrying. The Bible says, bread not. Amen. I'm telling you, I come to the point. I'm going to do everything I can do. Amen. I'm going to do what I can't do. I'm going to trust God. Because it's time that we realize that God is in control. He's in control of our environment. He's in control of our surroundings. He's in control of our finances. blessing. He's in control of our family. He's in control of all these things. And the Bible says one of my favorite verses come from a little old woman I used to go to church with. Romans 8:28. It says, all things work to the good of those who love the Lord. Anybody want some? Amen. I had our call according to their previous purpose. Amen. I want to tell you something. Hey, I don't know if anybody else believes it, but I want my children to believe it don't matter how bad the storm gets on the outside, as long as you'll stay on the inside, yeah, as long as you abide in God, God will take care of you. God will look after you. God will make you. God will raise you up above the shadow. There's hope that can still be found. Amen. Boy, I tell you what, we live in a world where, hey, I know that a lot of folks get mad at these bigger churches. Amen. But at least they don't act like a funeral home. Amen. Amen. Hey, somebody said, well, all they are is loud. Well, the reason folks don't come around to the smaller churches is because you like an old turtle. You done got scared, sunk your head back up in your shell, and you won't come out. Amen. And everybody thinks you're dead. Amen. I was going to be real calm. But when you get to realize, hey, when you come to grasp that God is in control, that lets me know that the devil can't do nothing to me. Amen. That God won't let it go. Amen. Amen. Somebody said, well, preacher, I know you can go out and find you somebody else. Go out there and find you one of them little weak back people that'll let you live any way you want to. Treat you like a 2-year-old instead of the grown up that you're supposed to be. Let him tell you some sweet tale and let you go home, dry up and wind up in the world again. Amen. But I ain't gonna give up because God let me know I'm still in control. Amen. All right. We realize here, see, now listen to me. This is what's happened. This little fellow, this one leopard, has realized he has come to grasp. He has got a hope to. Amen. Listen to me. Amen. He has got a hope. He has showed us that, listen, there's still hope for me. Amen. Listen to me today. Amen. Just realizing it is not enough, Brother Paul. Amen. Just realizing it is not enough. Hey, listen to me. I've got scripture. I might not get it all preached, but I learned. God will just let me preach it as He wants me to get it. Amen. But just hearing about it, you got to come to the realization that it'll work. Amen. Hey, listen to me. I got anybody here that realizes that, listen to me, that God is still in control of your life. God can help you get through a drug problem, an alcohol problem, any kind of problem you got. God can help you walk through it. God can put you back to playing the guitar. God can put joy back in your heart. He can put your kids back in your heart. He can give you a reason to live. Listen to me, and I got to say this, and I got to hurry. Amen. Listen to me. There's a lot of saved folks that the devil has control over your life. You believe him more than you believe God. Amen. Why, God can tell you everything's going to be all right, and then the devil show up and tell you it ain't going to work, and you'll believe the devil. You'll go home defeated. You'll go home brokenhearted. But God said, I'm going to fix it. Amen. Listen to me. All right, we found out this morning that God's in control. So that no longer means I have to stay a leper. And when you look at leprosy in the Bible, it's a type and shadow of sin itself. Amen. That means I no longer have to live in the world. I can come out of the world. Amen. I can be a separated folk. I ain't no longer got to be bound by the ties of the world. But don't you believe the devil when he says, I got you. Amen. Because God can tell him to let you go. Amen.
Listen to me.
Real quietly now, let's get into this real little bit deeper. We find, we know, we realize in this morning
that God's in control. Remember Naaman in the book of Kings heard that there was a man in this little handmaid's country that could do him some good. Amen. But just hearing about it didn't do no good. He had to go over and realize it himself. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Y'all ever read that? Amen. There's a lot of folks heard, but they've never come to the realization. Amen. I'm talking about folks that's been through the fire. You've come to realize. Amen. Paul himself told Timothy. Amen. In 2 Timothy chapter number 1, verse number 12, he said, I have been persuaded. Amen. Which means I had to go lose some things. I've been shipwrecked. I've been beaten. I've been thrown out of somebody. But he says, I found out that I've come to the realization that he's able to keep those things that I'm able, that I have committed under him that day. I got any folks in the house that's been through the fire that know that God can, that God will, that God wants to, that God will help you, God wants to help you. If you'll let God help you, he will, amen. Listen to me. I know Mama off my text a little bit. How does she know? Because we get in the truck on the way to church, I go over it with her. Amen. I say, Mama, this is what we're going to try to talk about this morning. Amen. And she said, preacher, you go over it. Amen. It wouldn't hurt some of y'all to go over some things. Amen. Before you come to church, you'd be better prepared. Amen. To have church, you go over things a little bit before you get here. That's the reason you can't comprehend it. Because it's all new to you, amen. But if you go over it a little bit, amen, to get ready to have church, then God can bless you, amen. Boy, I tell you what, I know how you feel. And once I be young, bold up, thank you. That's the way I feel this morning. I come to preach the word in the inspiration and the power of God. I ain't scared. Whether you like me or whether you don't, I ain't worried about going to dinner with you. I ain't worried about surviving my life. I just come to preach the word. I come to let them know that God is still in control. Amen. Preacher, I thought if I sat on the back row, you wouldn't bother me. That's what the devil thought. Amen. Hey, I got a God that walks all over the church. Amen. Amen.
Yes. I've got nephews, amen, that tell me I'm old-fashioned and I'm too loud, amen, but they asked me to marry them.
You know what I felt, Pop Scott? I was so proud when he did. He said, you know what I felt? I said, he wants something that's real to stand up, right? He got to look out. Amen. Those want something that's real. I want you to realize that God is real, amen. All right. And I want, let's go. Come on, Ted, let's go. Amen. Listen, he realized how good God is and how real he is and that God is still in control. And then he realized how much God cared for him. I want you to realize how much God cares for you this morning. Hey, listen to me. The Bible said that God loved you so much, Amanda, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's how I want you to realize what God give up for you. I want you to come and grasp. I want you to realize that he robbed heaven of the best thing that was there. Amen. And get it for me and you. And the Bible says in Romans chapter number 5, it said, while we were yet sinners, it said, Christ still came. And he died for me and you. It's real, amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. The devil's trying to sugarcoat it. He's trying to water it down. He don't want it to be loud. He don't want folks to get exuberant. He don't want folks to get hysterical. He don't want folks to realize, amen. Have you ever been in a ball game when the home team comes back in the 19th and wins, or in the last 2 minutes they score a touchdown? I think it's time that God spoke. We're in the last few minutes, and I want you to realize we're going to win the game, amen. Amen. Me and Chad and some of the other boys,
We've been watching these NBA playoffs, amen. And these teams have been winning by such margin, but there has been some good, there's been some happiness on the sidelines. I mean, they've been winning by 15, 20, 25 points. Amen. I want to tell you something. This time, the game's just about over. Amen. The clock's ticking down. We won, Chad. Jesus won the game. Amen. We won, amen. And it's time that we realize it, amen.
Yes.
Amen. I'm serious. Can you feel it? We're ahead. Amen. Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father. Amen. And we're ahead by so much. There ain't nothing the devil. The devil can hurt us, but he can't stop us. Amen. We're going to win. All right. Amen. Amen. I said that to say this. My son would play football for the Wyandotte Barrel Bulldogs. A good school. But during his grasp of high school, he spent 4 years there. He spent 3 years on the varsity. Amen. They played 10 games a year. Amen. Out of 30 games, we won two.
Lesson.
One a year. Amen. And we beat the same team both times. Thank God for that team. Amen. But they something happened on the side of Zach's football team that I don't know if anybody else realized, but God showed me they had lost all hope of winning. That when they walked out on the field, they already given the other team. They were bigger. They were better. They were better prepared. They said, if we win, it'll be an upset. Hey, I'm here to tell you, the church is thinking the same way. They say, if we prevail, it'll be a miracle. Though the miracle happened on the third day, Jesus said, just go ahead and endure it, people. Just endure it. Amen. God's trying to make you smile, and you sit there like you're something living, and God said, you just go ahead and endure life. Amen.
That's right.
That's
right.
That's
right.
Bless him, Lord.
I don't know if I do this. My daddy always said, you can tell by the dog that got big, he'll always bark. People, the preacher go to preaching. He ain't talking to me. Can I give you some advice? The best thing is to act the same way you were.
Yes.
Amen. Don't let nobody know. Well, preacher, you don't know what trouble I've got. You don't know what I'm going through. Will you please get up off your chair where you're sitting at right now and come down here and talk to a real God and realize that God will get you through whatever you're facing. It don't matter what it is. He'll get you through it. Amen. All right, let's go. He wants to. He cares. We're realizing that we don't have just a God that is powerful and that he can. Amen. He wants to. Amen. When they called out his name, amen, somebody get a hold to this. We've got a God that can hear us.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible said, in Isaiah chapter number 59, that his arm is not too short, that it cannot reach his children. I might not be getting the exact right. Or his ear too heavy, that he can hear us. Amen. Do you know God hears you?
Yes, sir.
Amen. I got me a list of points, but I know you're going to get... Listen to me, but listen, I want to tell you something. The first thing we need to realize after we realize that he's still in control and that he wants to help us, amen, and that we realize that he can, amen, we realize, listen to me, he don't have to. This is what we need to realize this morning. Amen. We take God for granted.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Amen. We take. Do you realize that Jesus did not have to die?
Right.
He did not have to die. Now, I did some research in Matthew chapter number 26. You are going to find where Jesus is talking. And he says, do you not know, do you not understand that I can call 12 leagues, that my Father has 12 leagues? Now, league is 1,000. Amen. That there's 12,000 angels. Just wait on me to call.
That's it.
Amen. He didn't have to die.
Bless you.
He didn't have to die for you. You need to realize that, Shane. He didn't have to die for Shane. He didn't have to die for Zach. He didn't have to die for Russell or Elijah. Amen. He didn't have to die for Brother Larry, but he did.
Amen.
So let's get down. Let's grab a hold of this. And let's realize why he really died. That the nails did not hold him on the cross.
Come on,
Frank.
Bless you.
Hey, we need to realize this because the devil wants you to think I killed him. The devil ain't killed nobody.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Doug. Yeah, amen. Now, why did God tell the devil about Job? He said you can have everything about him but his soul. That's his life. You know what I'm talking about?
Amen.
Amen. He said that belongs to me, because if God would have given the devil the power over his soul, he would have just killed him and gotten out of the way. He wouldn't have been a testimony against him. But God said you can have everything but that. Amen. The devil ain't never killed nobody. Boy, if I ever learn to do this in order, I'm going to be ready. Amen. Listen to me, but I'm telling you, Brother Burke. Listen to me. I'm telling you. Listen to me. That we serve a God. Amen. That did not have to die. He hung there because he seen us down through the channels of time. He, remember in the garden? Listen to me. I can show you that they was split. Somebody said he didn't feel it. You're a liar. Amen. Amen. Because he felt the agony. Amen. If he hadn't, he'd have never went into the garden of Gethsemane. He'd have never got down on his knees and said, Father, if it be your will, let this cup pass from me.
Yes, sir.
Amen. That's what he said.
How many times? Three times he prayed, right?
Yep.
Amen. And then all of a sudden he got to the point. Ain't it amazing when we pray, we get to the point. Nevertheless, Lord,
yes,
not thy will, not my will, but yours be done. You know, if we had some folks that would get out of their seats and come on down here and say, God, just forgive me for wanting everything my way and let me. Hey, listen to me. Brother Wayne, can I use you a minute? Amen. Just a bit. You know what that man did for me just this morning? Amen. He comes from a broken home. About a year ago, the devil got in his home. Drugs was there, tore him apart, his wife apart, put his kids in jail. All of a sudden, suddenly he comes to church. All of a sudden, he found Jesus. Amen. Been coming, been praying. All of a sudden, he handed me a wedding invitation. He said, preacher, me and my wife, we're getting married again. Amen. He said, my kids. The church has got one, and I'm going to tell the devil, you tore it apart, but I've got a God that's able to put it back together. I've got a God that you might separate it, but God will put it back together. Amen.
Amen.
Bless. We've got to realize what Jesus did for us.
That's right.
I mean, when we get a grasp on what he did for us, we won't complain so much about what we have to do for him.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
True. And I don't see what we got to complain about no way, bless God. We come to church once on Wednesday, twice on Sunday.
Yeah.
And he gives us about 6.5 days the rest of the week to do what we want.
Right.
Come on,
that's true.
I wish I could find a company that would supply my needs.
Yeah.
And look after me.
That's right.
And only ask me to work a day and a half a week.
Yeah.
Do you know what? Can somebody look at the preacher? I got something to tell you. Do you know you don't even qualify as a full-time employee unless you work 40 hours a week?
Blessing.
This earth, you don't get no benefits until you become a full-time employee. Lots of that from the time we put in. God pays us twice as much as we worth, amen. We need to realize that I'm getting way ahead. But we need to realize we've got to get in God.
Amen.
I mean, he said he supplied needs according to his riches in glory, Brother Burke. Amen. And listen to me, the United States might be in debt, but heaven don't owe nothing.
That's right.
How about it? something like that. Amen. The devil hates this kind of preaching. Because when you get folks to realize you might have trouble at your home. Amen. You might have trouble at your home. You might have trouble. But I want you to realize that there's a God that can fix it. Amen. 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 Ain't that good? Don't they look at that smile. She ain't smiling at the preacher, but she's smiling because she's got a God that's going to help her and her family. She's got a God that's going to help her raise her kid. She's got a God that's going to help her. Oh, if somebody get a hold of that, and we've got a God that's going to help us this morning.
Amen.
Lord, I'm going to ask you something, brother. Listen to this. Amen. We got a God. We need to realize that we got a God that won't leave us.
Amen.
Boy, that ought to be exciting right there. God told Joshua, he said, I want you to go lead them children. I want you to go to Jericho. But he said, Joshua, I'm going to tell you something. I'll never leave you. How about that? He said, well, if I ask you to do something, I'll be right there. He said, I won't fail you, Joshua. Amen. He said, listen to me. Be of good courage. I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. Or I'll never fail you, Joshua.
Bless him.
Realize that. Let that soak in. Let that soak in. Let that soak in. Get a hold of this, young folks. If you've got a real God, you've got a God that is a giving God and a God that will not leave you. But Jordan, he'll be right beside you when things get the darkest. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Preacher, I ain't got no friends. If you've got Jesus, you've got the only friend you need. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that he is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. Amen. I'm sorry I can't preach a defeated message to defeated people. Amen. It just ain't in the book. Amen. Amen. Even the lepers that sat outside the city walls said, let's get up and do something, bless God. If we don't, we're just going to die.
Right.
And they went to the enemy's camp and found out that they lost. They already run. Oh, they saw y'all. Y'all just realized the power of God, what God can do in your life. Amen. He could change you. He could change you. He could change you. Let's go. All right. Now, we, after getting out of context, after getting out of my line of order here, let's try to get back in. Because after we realize that God's in control, that God's in power, amen, that God cares, that God's a giving God. Hey, when you say giving God, amen, what do you mean? God's a God that's giving second chances.
Yes.
I'm so glad God don't look on us like the world does.
Amen.
Because when the world looked at me, they would look at me like I was broke. They look at me like I had no future.
That's right.
What do you call a one-legged old carpenter that ain't got but a few years left up there in frame housing that don't have a nest egg? Hey, amen. That's what you call it.
Bless him.
You know what I'm talking about, Brother Jamie?
Yeah.
Amen. You got one good leg. You know why I'm talking about me and you, Brother Grady. You've been in it longer than I have. You probably got fruit jars all over the backyard. But poor Frankie, he wasn't smart enough to put none back there.
Bless him, Lord.
Anybody know what a fruit jar is?
Yeah.
It's what old folks used to put the money in. Yeah. They go out in the backyard, they buried it there. Amen. And they keep it till a rainy day or a hard day. And that's what my dad used to tell me. You need to get you some fruit jar. I didn't have enough sense to have some fruit jar. I blew up trying to spend every dime that I made. Amen. And I'm not getting on nobody. Hey, but listen to me. I'm telling you this morning. Amen. The only hope that I have, Miss Barbara, is in God. Amen. Let me tell you what Dale said. You'll be broke. Amen. You'll be broke and you won't be able to work. See, I climb in houses and when you get up there with one leg, you do the bunny hop. Amen. He always tells me, you'll never make it. Hey, I'm not being ugly to y'all, but I'm telling you the gospel truth. The devil is spreading defeating rumors all over the building. Amen. He is meeting with folks everywhere saying, I'll get you back. Amen. He is coming to you and getting around and saying, I'll have you win that. I'll get you to come back down that long road. I'll get you to fall in that trap again. Amen. And there's a bunch of y'all. I've got to be careful because that long road's closer to you than you realize. Amen. Some of y'all act like the most self-godly, ungodly, right? I mean, y'all the right, most righteous folks act like butter would melt in your mouth. And if we was to open your closet door, there'd be so many skeletons hanging in your closet. Amen. You wouldn't even want to come back to church. church. And I want to tell you something, there ain't nothing, nothing in secret. Amen. If God won't let come out, amen. I just keep acting like that bigot, amen, that judges everybody else. I wouldn't let him preach because of this. I wouldn't let him sing because of that. I got news for you. That little woman called the very act of adultery. Amen. Jesus didn't condemn her, but he said, I did. We're all going to condemn. Where are your condemners? We're the ones that are condemning you. She says, I have that. He said, well, then go and sin no more.
Amen.
I got me any of them to go and sin no more folks in the house.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Blessings.
I don't think I'm going to get called up anywhere no time soon. Listen to me. Preacher, what are you preaching this morning? I want you to realize that God is on your side. He is not pushing you down, but he is preparing you. He is getting you ready. I'm here to tell you, amen, I don't like to look at nobody, but there's folks here that's got a problem.
Yeah.
And you ain't going to be able to handle this problem by yourself. Yeah. This message is for you. God wants you to realize that he's standing there wanting to help you. He has helped us. He will help you if you will only commit yourself unto him. But I can tell you what's wrong. These folks that on Sunday they want to commit, and on Monday they're ready to turn it loose.
That's it.
Hey, man, listen to me. I'm losing you. I got to hurt you. Brother Larry, he is a God. Amen. Listen to me. That we realize what he is, who he is. Listen to me. And what happened here is this little man realized what God had done for him. And he realized by the law, Zach, when we go back to the law, he realizes that Jesus didn't even have to do anything, didn't even have to take or take time with him or anything. Jesus could have sent him on his way, and by the law, he'd have been right. But Jesus said, oh, listen to me. Jesus called, he heard their cry, and he sent them to the priest so that the priest could set them free physically. But Jesus waited there so he could set them free wholeheartedly.
Amen.
Amen. Listen to me. What made him come back? Because he realized that Jesus didn't have to, but he did.
Yes, sir.
But
yes,
he did. Sir. He did. He didn't have to, but he did. He helped them. He didn't have to, but he did. Now, what happened is when this little man figured out what had happened, this is what happened. I want you to, when you get home, I want you to look in the 12th chapter of John. I'm going to hurry and go over just a few things, and then we'll go. 12th chapter of John, you're going to find a woman named Mary there. She is sister to Martha and Lazarus. And Lazarus, you know him as the one that died that Jesus raised from the dead. Mary, we find Mary there. And Jesus is preparing the disciples for his departure. He is fixing to get ready, amen, to go down the cross. And all of a sudden, Mary comes into the house, and she has a alabaster box. And for some of you that don't know what an alabaster box is, that's the ointment, amen, that is used to anoint kings, amen. And you know what she did? She broke this box. Now, before this box was broke, amen, before this box was broke, it was said to be worth a year's wages at that time. Oh, that's a lot of money right there. A whole year's wages. But you know what? When she realized who Jesus was, she was willing to give it up.
Amen.
When she realized who he was, she said, it's not hard for me to give it up when I realize what he's going to do for me. Amen. And the Bible said, 1 Matthew and Mark said that she poured it on his head. Amen. Oh, but John said, we find her at the feet of Jesus. Amen. And she poured it on his feet, and she took the hair of her head, and she began to wipe his feet. She realized, but listen to me, there was a devil in that day, just like there was here. Hey, Mark, and listen to me, Matthew and Mark does not single him out, but John hits the nail on the head. He said, oh, Judas spoke up and said, what she laid this box for? Could it not have been sold, amen, and the money given to the poor? And I want to tell you something, amen, Judas was not worried about the poor, amen. He was not worried, amen, about God, amen. He was a thief. The Bible even says that he was a thief.
Amen.
He wouldn't worry. And Mary had realized who he was. He's my king. You know who the king is? He is the leader of the people. Go back and read about in the 1 Samuel where David, and 2 Samuel where David got to be king. The people looked to the king for leadership.
All right.
They looked to him for guidance.
Yeah.
Amen. They looked to him as an example. Whatever the king did, that's what they do.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Mainly is recognize Jesus for who he is. Now these other disciples ain't recognized him yet. They will before long, but they have not come to the recollection who he really is. When I get church folks to come to the realization of who he is, you don't have a hard time having church no more.
That's right.
Stop right here. You got to say this. How many of y'all realize it's Jesus' day more than what time it is right now?
That's right.
Amen. How many of you folks here, see, people make me get ugly. I want to be sweet. I do. I have a hard time finding friends. And the ones I get, I want to keep.
Amen.
But people come in church and they don't realize this is God's day, not your day. Preacher, I've got appointments for this and that and that. When did, God, please, just get sweet. Amen. God wants to know when's the last time you looked at God's calendar before you made an appointment?
Amen.
Blessing.
Bless, brother.
Amen. People want to use our fellowship hall on Sunday. And finally, we come to the thing. We want to help everybody. But you know what? We told them they couldn't use it until after 2 o'clock. Why? Church is supposed to be over at 12. And then Larry spoke up and said, y'all ain't got a preacher like ours. Amen. I'm being honest with you. But you know what? I'm telling you right now, look at me, Doug. I'm telling you right now, there's folks sitting in here right now who won't realize more about what time it is and where they got to go this evening than the Jesus and what he's wanting to do in folks' life. I'm serious, brother. I'm serious. The realization is, when can I get out of here?
Amen. Yes, I'm blessing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. When can I get out of here? And God's made it as comfortable for you as he can.
Yeah.
Some of you are sitting in here now saying, preacher can read minds. No, sir. But you know what? I can't read mine, but I can take hints. Amen. Amen. Listen to me. We realize, Mary has realized who he is. And when Mary realized who he was, she found herself at Jesus' feet, just like this little leper did. Amen. She found herself on her knees at his feet, recognizing who he is. If I could get some folks to recognize him, we'd have an altar full. Amen. It don't matter what other folks say. Can I stop right here and share a good bit? Do you know what? Jesus, can you realize something? Jesus don't realize, care who you are. Realize that it don't matter who you are. Jesus wants to help you.
Amen.
Now, this is a good point, and I'll run over it, and I'll go back and pick it up. How many times do we read that this is a Samaritan? Now there's a reason. Who he was does not, the writer does not put this down because he's a bigot or because he has something against Samaritans, but it is to give us word. See, the Jews were not to have anything to do. They didn't like the Samaritans. They called them half-breeds. Amen. They called them people that didn't belong anywhere. Amen. But the Bible keeps telling us that this man was a Samaritan for us to realize it don't matter who you are, Jesus wants to help you. Amen.
That's right.
Boy, when you get to the realization that Jesus even helped me. How about that? How about that? All right, let's go a little further. Amen. You ain't be getting us a song. All right. That's hope, some of y'all. Amen. But smile, so when you'd be surprised if the folks and I say, you ain't get a song, how many folks?
Amen.
Amen. Boy, it's like I lifted a load off of them. They said, we know we ain't got to leave 20 more minutes.
I want you to come to realization how good God is.
Yeah.
I want you to come to realization that it don't matter where you go. See, now I'm not staying with my points as good as I should, but I get wrapped up in myself, and I get wrapped up in the moment, and I get wrapped up in God, and I just say whatever God puts on my heart. But I found time that folks realize it don't matter how far you went away. I find it in Luke chapter 15. When a little old boy left his father's house in search of a great life.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden he got down near the hog pen.
Yeah.
And the Bible says when he come to his right mind, and God sent me down, he said when he realized what he left.
Yeah.
When he realized what he left, what he had given up for the world. He'd give up the peace that was at the Father's house. He'd give up the provisions that was at the Father's house. He'd give up the protection that was at the Father's house. He'd give it all up for a worldly good time.
Yeah.
Just walk away from it. But the Bible says that when he come to his right mind, when he realized how many servants at my Father's house have bread enough, not just for me, but to spare. And then he realized, I know what I'll do. I realize I'll just get up and just go home.
And
I'll just go home. All you got to do this morning is just realize you can go home. I know that the Wizard of Oz is nothing to do with this or nothing at all, but you have to give the preacher a little. Dorothy went everywhere looking for a way to get home. And that when she got down at the end of the picture, they said, all you got to do is click your heels. Three times, and you'll go home. That was a dream. This is reality.
Yes,
all you got to do this morning is get up and come to the altar and ask God. Say, God, I know I don't know you. I want to be saved. God wants you to realize that he is waiting on you. Right now there's so much in this, and you ought to look at this. See, that little fellow, all he did was realize that he could go home. He could go home. And when he got there, it was more than he ever expected.
Yeah.
See, he realized he could go home. He was expecting just to be a servant.
Yeah.
Oh, just be, but that ain't what he found. When he got there, he found that there was a father looking for him and that ran to meet him and put his arms around his neck and embraced him and blessed him. Put a ring on his finger, which meant that y'all know what a ring means. You know the reason that father put that ring on him? He said, because I'll always love you. I'll always love you. No matter where you've been, no matter how nasty you smell, I'll always love you. Jeremiah said God's love was an everlasting love.
Amen.
He put a robe on and he put his shoes on his feet. I heard the preacher preach that I cannot take this, but he said the reason he put shoes on because he was not a slave any longer. But you know what? Slaves went barefooted.
Right.
But children wore shoes.
Amen.
He said, oh, somebody. God wants somebody to realize in your life that I am the best thing. I'm what you've been looking for in everything in the world. Realize that I am it. Now listen to me. Listen to me. What are you going to do? Will you come to the realization today or will you be deceived? Will you be deceived as times before and let the devil talk to you out of what's real? Because see, right now there's something talking to your heart and it's telling you, go home. Realize that God wants you to get things right in your life. He wants to save you. He wants you to become part of the family. He wants you to get things right between you and him. Notice one thing, and Glenn, y'all come on. Chad, the Father doesn't ask who to grieve.
Amen. No, sir.
Nowhere in that scripture does he start digging into his son's past. He says, go kill the fatted calf. He said, we couldn't have a feast. He said, He finally comes to the realization that the best thing is right here. The devil's got a lot to offer in this world. He's got a lot to put in front of our kids, and he's got a lot to offer adults. We live in a day where there's more folks getting in trouble with computers and sitting at home looking at stuff on computers than ever before, and it's nothing but the devil. Will you turn loose of the world this morning? Will you turn loose and accept him? Realize what he is and who he wants to be in your life, and let him be real. While we stand, thank the Lord for that song. You can be seated. Still felt like some could have come, some looking for something, some still not come to the realization that Jesus is just what you need.
That's amen. Right.
But I love you today, and I thank you for your good attention, and I love you with all my heart. And if I don't mean to be ugly. I just want to bring you to the light. I want to let you know that the reason you're here is because of God's goodness.
That's right.
Because of God's goodness. Amen?
Yes, sir.
And listen to me. We ought to praise him while we can.
Yes, sir.
Hey, amen. Hey, and I love you today, and I thank you for everything you've done for us. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Brother Frankie, I just want to stand this morning and say that I thank him for all his many blessings for everything that he's ever done for me in my life. And, you know, I'm not ashamed for the things that God has brought us through. And I just, my heart's beating out of my chest. And I just had to stand and say this. I want to ask this church to pray for Chris. Chris is going through a tough time with his little boy. He's not getting to see his son. And I want to tell you, 3 years ago, Scott and I had to make a decision, and we told our son that Mitchell can't ride in the car with you because we didn't know if he was going to be driving down the road and drinking with our grandson in the car. And I want you to know, Chris, Mitchell's going to have to look at Chris and tell me where you live today.
I'll look
at
my dad.
So God is able.
Appreciate that. God's good.
Amen.
God's good, ain't he?
Amen.
God's good. God's good. I just love the Lord. I love being around God's folks right there.
Amen.
Something happens when you get around God's folks and folks begin to pray right there. So remember that. Got a card I want to read right fast. Or here, Jenny, you can read it right there. There you go. That's their wedding right there.
Together with their children, Michelle DeWayne requests the pleasure of your company as they exchange vows on Saturday, the 18th day of June at 5 o'clock in the evening, Eagle Grove Baptist Church, Monroe, Georgia. Reception to follow.
Amen. Amen. We appreciate the Lord. All the church is invited. You come be with that. And that's another home that God's putting back together. Amen. We ought to be thankful to the Lord for that. Remember this afternoon now. At 3 o'clock, Brother Doug and Brother Dean then will be at the Russell Nursing Home. Do we go in the front door, Brother Dean, or around to the side?
We're going in the front lobby there by the highway.
All right. They letting us in the front door. So, so remember that.
Are you looking for a place to worship God in spirit and in truth? Hello, I'm Frankie Green, pastor of Trinity Baptist Church in Auburn, Georgia. We would like to invite you to be in our service with us. Sunday school starts at 10, with morning worship at 11. Sunday evening worship begins at 6, and Wednesday night prayer service at 7. We are a King James Bible-believing, fundamental, independent Baptist church reaching out to those who need a special touch from God. For more information, you can visit us at trinitybaptistauburn.com or on Facebook at Trinity Baptist Church, Auburn. We welcome you to Trinity Baptist Church, where you will become part of a family.